Hello, dissenters. My name is Italics, and I am here today back in Tropico 5, where we are going to work on building up a new civilization on a brand new island with a brand new dynasty. We are going to start things off super quick here because I have taken on a trade route with some smugglers to export some cotton for 5 years, 57 months remaining. We're going to build us a cotton plantation to start this video off with. So I've got cotton selected already. I have not decided where to build it. However, there's some obvious locations that do look very nice. For example, right here is completely green, and we can kind of make it opposite of the other plantation. It's going to take up a lot of room, but that's a great place to start. We've already got a default corn plantation, and we're going to start things off by also making some pineapples, so that's yet another plantation we need to make, because the Crown wants to extend my mandate by 6 months for some pineapples. Seems like a good deal. They really want some pineapples. They just don't know how to contain themselves. All right, so Plantation Central here in Turtle Rock. Yes, it's the name of this new location. And you're thinking, Italics, why the other place was called The Rock? Why did you just add turtle in front of it? It doesn't make any sense. Allow me to share with you. See this guy right here with the purple pants? Yeah, this is my leader. Check him out. Donato Turtle. Yeah, I'm going for the Ninja Turtles here in case it kind of went over your head. He's got purple suit, bald head. His name's close to Donatello. That's all I got, guys. Turtle Dynasty, here we go. What's my new quest? All right, we got to build a library and get more tasks. That is fair enough. We, of course, need a library. So it should be somewhere around the research tab. And I think I'm just going to make it across the street, if we can get this completely even, from our little base of operations here. And we're definitely going to go for a militarized aspect this time around. I want to be able to defend myself against the evil Crown here that we're getting the royal commendations from. Take their money and run. That's all we can do. 12-month mandate extension or money. We've got 4 years right now, so let's go with the money, I think, just to try to bring that negative balance back in. And we should start making a lot more money from these new plantations. Now, an issue we have to be careful of is we're going to have some open jobs, 15 to be exact, because we've been building too many different new possible areas for people to work in without giving them the homes to support those jobs. So let's kind of make these staggered across the street from the other homes. All right, so 3 more should be good to get us started here. We're still doing construction on the library. And I think we just finished up on this plantation for pineapples. Now that we have obeyed the Crown and made a plantation for pineapples, they want 3,000 pineapples. And all I get in return is 6-month mandate extension. I told you they like those pineapples. I don't know. I like pineapples too, so I can't really fault them there. Something else we should probably start working on is the religion. Let's just look at the happiness. We can see what's at 0. It's a great way to keep in touch with your people. Religion, healthcare, and entertainment. All right, so you know what that means. Tavern, Catholic mission, something else. While my explorers are rediscovering this gold mine, I think it's time to start working on the mission for the Catholic mission. And we might get that quest anyway. No, this is for a llama ranch, but we get revolutionary support, which, of course, we are going to need. So, Catholic mission, we're just going to kind of do this fairly quickly. Enough room for a road to go in between. Good enough for me. All right, so we're going to make some definite military towers here. Probably a military base back behind us with some more towers surrounding it, perhaps. We're definitely going to do that before we declare independence. Have we discovered this mine yet, game? Indeed, we have. All right, so making the mine is going to help us out with the money situation, and let's check on our trade as well. As the mine is being worked on by these lovely people here, I love the clothes that they're wearing. They look like pilgrims. We have a new research unlock, so we can get some farm upgrades and start working on some other interesting things. Let's just go with the military fort right off the bat. We are going to militarize hardcore here. Oh dear, another unexpected pregnancy. What are we going to do? Build a new Catholic mission. We've already got a Catholic mission. Does that one not count? Certainly not going to pay to keep things quiet. I love a good scandal. Let's go with love a good scandal, okay? I think I'm going to go with residential construction's 5% cheaper. That seems like it might be the most useful. And here is our new turtle, Baltazar. I don't think we get to rename him, unfortunately. So the closest one, reminds me of Bulbasaur. So this is like more like a Pokemon. I'm tempted to just keep him like this. I don't really care at this point. If you won't let me name him, what's the point? We'll at least give him a different color. He's got blue. He's got Leonardo's blue already. So let's just make him blue all the way around. There we go. All right, all done. Check out the progress that Italics has made on Turtle Rock. We've got the Opera House. And I kind of like what I did with the roads. If I can pat myself on the back, I've got a road coming in between the Catholic Mission and the library, and it splits around the back of the Opera House. And I'm planning on building some mansions right out front here. I think it's just generally a good idea. So hopefully we've got some more jobs available for our people now. We're going to need some college education. Luckily someone's working there. And I need some more basic jobs too. So a ranch is in order because llamas are in high demand. With some llamas, we're going to get a mandate extension. So where to play? There's really not any good spots for llamas. Bunch of yellow, just a little bit of green back here along this road, I guess, would not kill me. I don't know where to place this exactly. Let's just put it a couple spaces over right along this road. It's close enough to the bright green spot to count. So lumber mill has been unlocked, but we don't even have a basic logging camp. So it doesn't really do us a whole lot of good. We can make the lumber mill, but we don't have any logging camp. So why not just go ahead and make that too? Over here in this little neck of the woods. Seems good. You see what I did there? Neck of the woods. I'm so smart. And just kind of drag it backwards in between all the trees. Despite my heavy spending, my high construction we're doing here, we've got plantation, we've got a ranch, and a logging camp going in simultaneously. We've still got like $10,000 right now because we're exporting things, people are happy, and speaking of people, let's do what I was talking about earlier and make a couple mansions out here. I don't know if there's going to be a good way to kind of line these up. We'll just leave a space in the middle. Two mansions is a good start. Right in front of the Opera House, prime real estate, also on the beach. Oh baby, that's gonna be some expensive land right there. I know I'm probably queuing up too many things simultaneously, but at the same time, we are completing our goals. We're getting to import some revolutionaries. I don't really want the money, but the trade routes could be nice. I think we're still trading right now. Let's see, cotton is still going out to the smugglers. Let's check on our trading here. Still got 9 months remaining on our contract. We've exported 11,000 so far. Meanwhile, at the palace, we got even more revolutionary support possible with the Foreman technology. Sure, we'll take that. As well as exporting 3,500 bananas. Are we already producing bananas, or do we have to make a banana plantation? Oh my, I think we have to make a banana plantation. Okay, either way, I'm just kind of accepting everything at the moment. I also, what was I doing? I don't even remember. Oh, I was looking at upgrades. Okay, we have a ranch over here with a possible upgrade. Job quality increased by 10. Sure, we'll pay $800 to make the job quality go up. Let's take a look at, can we upgrade the logging camp as well? Unlocked in Cold War and World Wars. Oh, we do have a banana plantation. Great. And this one lets the job quality go up by 20 and workers' wealth increase. Buying upgrades all over the place. Is there one more ranch somewhere around here? Italics does not recall. Also, who built a shack right behind this mansion? Is this like this person's extended family? And what else did they want? More food? Okay, we can do food. We can do food. Worf is going to catch some fish. I think that's pretty good. Pretty solid idea here. But how? Okay, it goes about this far in. We'll put the next dock on the other side over there. Put two spaces. Get a road going in over to it. There we go. All right, so that should help us out on a bunch of different fronts. We got entertainment going in, we got more food variety going in, happiness should be going up, we're almost at 40%, and I think we can declare independence very soon. So remember when I had to export some fruit earlier? Yeah, the crown wants another 10,000 fruits, but the revolutionaries are not as adamant about that. In fact, I think they would rather me not do anything. So I could either get 6 months on completion, if prices should not change, or no mandate extension and increased revolutionary support. Let's go this route. I just want to get as much support as possible. So while we're getting ready to rebel, you know what time it is. It's time to militarize. Oh, here's my fort. Where is it gonna go? I think we're gonna put the fort right next to the beach. There's not really another good spot out here unless I put it behind our capital, our palace, which I don't know if that's ideal, but I don't know if I'd want it really this close to the front lines either. Let's just go with this, okay? We're going to place a fort down here. We're going to place two guard towers next to it. One on this side, and then one on this side. And then we're going to place a road going around the fort itself, which we should have enough space to do so. Good. And we're going to place more than just a couple of those guard towers, guys. I learned my lesson last time. Not going to make the same mistake again. You can trust me on that one. And we're going to have two next to the palace. And then we're going to kind of scatter at least two more out here just to help our people. Here goes construction. I love just watching these things rise up. And we should have our military fort here very soon. Oh, dear. Tornado? Did you just say there's a tornado on the island? What is this, banished? And on top of that, building costs have been increased by 20%. Thank you, King. We're going to slow this down just a little bit so the tornado doesn't just rampage through everything. It may miss us, guys. It hit something out here. What is this? The logging camp, and it's moving towards the mine. As long as it stays away from the center of town. Oh, we have 52% independent. Well, 51, excuse me. Apparently, people were like, hey, look, a tornado. Let's declare independence right now, shall we? I think it is. It's finally disappearing. Thank goodness. That could have been a lot worse. 8 citizens were killed, though, so that's not great in a population of only a little over 100. And we got $3,300 as aid. So their lives were worth $3,300. I think that's worthwhile, in my opinion. Well, my friends, I think it is time to revolt. I know we only have 47% rating right now because I accidentally refused a revolutionary quest and they did not like that very much. But nonetheless, I think the quest is still here. So let's go ahead and proclaim independence now. I think we're ready. Let them come. You guys remember how this went last time? Let's see how it fares this time. We've got all three are going to be attacking our military fort with our two guard towers. Hopefully the fort is good. Hopefully it's better than the guard towers by themselves. But even if they destroy these, they have to make it through four more guard towers, and the palace itself. So I have confidence in my troops. We're going to kind of speed this up because it was kind of lengthy last time. I love how my troops are shooting their troops, but their troops are shooting my guard tower, but yet my troops are still dying. Let's see. We're about to lose this battle. They've already destroyed one of our towers. Oh, dear. The fight rages on. We have slain one of their forces. Our troops are under direct fire, taking heavy losses. We've lost one guard tower, but they seem to be evenly matched. Thanks to the help of this military fort, I believe we are now winning the battle. I see lots of dead troops on the field here. They look like they're about to be routed. We've got 6 out of 8 colonial infantry left. They've only got 9 troopers so far. Apparently, none of them know how to aim these muskets, even though they are almost point-blank range. Where are the formations? Where is your training? I don't know what just happened. There was a giant window that popped up, but I believe we have won our independence through combat, and I did not even get to read what we just unlocked because I was talking and not looking at the screen. All right, we've advanced to the new era. We've got actual streets and roads now, so the road system has been upgraded. Look at all these new buildings we can make. I'm sure some of them have to be researched in order to unlock. Textile mills, rum distillery, tenements and regular houses. We've got a restaurant now. Cabaret, ancient ruins. We've nothing on this tab yet. Goodness. No tourism until the Cold War, apparently. Groceries, clinics, church, police station. Oh dear, there's so much to do now. If you guys enjoyed this video and you want to see me continue this sandbox, please let me know by leaving a like on the videos that you enjoy. Look at these trucks. Oh, baby. Oh, it's still dirt road way out here, though. I guess that makes sense. Thank you so much for watching this video. My name is Italics, and I will see you next time.